So very good morning all. So today I'm going to share something about this mass transfer operations in process industries. So in mass transfer, the main principles involved in mass transfer is diffusion. So the diffusion is the movement of component from one phase to another phase. So here there should be some driving force should be there. So the driving force for mass transfer is concentration gradient. So what is mean by this concentration? So this concentration is nothing but which is the unit for the mass, how many mass is transferred, so which is represented in terms of molar concentration, we call. So the unit for molar concentration, kilomole per meter cube. So the main driving force for this diffusion is concentration gradient. So the best example we can say is this removal of ammonia in the process of gas absorption. So that means suppose air ammonia mixture is there, we want to absorb that ammonia, because this ammonia is a pollutant, so you have to remove this ammonia, so by using some suitable solvent. So we usually use water as a solvent for absorbing ammonia gas. So there are two types of diffusion. So one is the molecular diffusion, another one is eddy diffusion. So in molecular diffusion, so which happens due to the virtue of the thermal energy of the component, the particles will move. So diffusion means movement of molecules or transfer of molecules from one place to another. So if it is, happens by virtue of their thermal energy, it is called molecular. If suppose the movement is given by external force, then it is called eddy diffusion. So there are two types of diffusion. One is molecular diffusion, another one is eddy diffusion. So this molecular diffusion is a very slow process. So it happens in a zigzag manner, like random movement of individual molecules taking place. Whereas in eddy diffusion, so we have, it is a bulk transport will be taking place due to the external force given, either in terms of agitation or some blowers, fans we are using in order to increase this movement. So this is the faster process and turbulent motion is involved. So the law of diffusion, which is very important in order to explain the diffusion, so some law will be used, so which is used to define my flux of the component. So the flux is directly proportional to the diffusivity. So the flux is directly proportional to the concentration gradient, so which is represented by JA is equal to minus DAB into DCA by DZ, where DAB is our diffusivity and DCA by DZ is the concentration gradient. Next we will see the steady state molecular diffusion in fluids. So we call generally fluids. So we are going to discuss detail about the steady state molecular diffusion in liquids as well as gases. So the very basic flux equation is this molar flux. So that is Na is equal to, so which has the two component. So one is the flux due to the component, and the flux due to the another component. So this flux can be derived by using this flux equation, so which is Na is equal to Na by Na plus Nb into C dAb by Z into ln of Na by Na plus Nb minus Ca2 by C divided by Na plus Nb minus Ca1 by C. So here dAb is our diffusivity, C is our molar concentration, Z is the thickness or the distance of the movement. So this is the molecular diffusion in gases. So usually the gas, if it is ideal gas, so we can use this ideal gas law, which is PV is equal to nRT, where this N by V is our concentration. So N by V is represented as C, so which is PT by ZRT. So if you apply this law, so you can get the flux equation in terms of this C can be written as PT by RT. So the basic equation, flux equation, can be replaced by this form. So in this form, this Na by Na plus Nb has two cases. So one is either the possibility of steady state diffusion of gas A through the non-diffusing gas, that means a stagnant gas B. So in this case, the flux of B is zero. So you can say this Na by Na plus Nb is equal to 1 because Nb is 0. So if you substitute this, you will get the flux equation Na is equal to dAb Pt by ZRT into ln of, so this Pt minus Pa2 by Pt minus Pa1. So it can be again written as the total pressure Pt equal to partial pressure of the component A and B. So Pt equal to Pa1, Pa2 plus Pb2 or Pa1 plus Pb1. So by using this relationship, you can modify. So you will get, so this Pbm is the logarithmic mean difference in terms of pressure, partial pressure of the component B at position 2 and position 1. So this is the final equation in terms of this pressure. This can be also written in terms of small ya1, small ya2. Small y means mole fraction of component A at position 1 and position 2. So in the second case, if both the components are diffusing, then it becomes equimolar counter diffusion. Then in this case, you have to use this equation instead of the previous equation because Nb is not zero. So in this case, Na is equal to minus Nb. So if you substitute, you will get Na is equal to minus dAb into dou CA by dou Z. And if you integrate and apply this equation, so you can get Na is equal to dAb by ZRT into Pa1 minus Pa2. So thank you. So today we have seen the very basic mass transfer operations involved in many industries, like diffusion and types of diffusion and steady state molecular diffusion in liquids and gases. So thank you.